Blessings, beautiful soul. Welcome to our ritual for forgiveness. This is going to be very, very helpful for you if you are just feeling any tension between either yourself and another person, or even between your past and your present. A lot of times, the most important person we have to forgive is ourselves. I'm gonna ask you to pause this video and just grab something to write on, your pen and paper or a special notebook. And if you feel called, maybe warm up some nice hot cacao and light an incense, like set the scene. Light a candle, maybe bring your favorite crystals. And if you wanna have some soft, gentle music playing in the background, I'm gonna link what I recommend below. So now that you have all your materials, everything you'll need for the ritual, we're gonna be getting into a nice, easy meditative space. And when we connect with anybody in our lives, no matter how fleeting, we create the energetic cords from our solar plexus to their solar plexus, Manipura connection. And sometimes we can create very strong cords with people that we have had agreements with in past lives, you know. Might see someone in the grocery store, make eye contact, have that recognition, keep moving on, you know? It's like those soul connections, like we've known each other before. We might have strong ties with family, friends, loved ones, or even pets. And it's important to just like brushing your teeth, take care of these energetic cords. The deeper the connection with another soul, the stronger the cords are, and the more easily affected you are by their energy. So sometimes we'll close our eyes and think of somebody and start feeling a certain way. It's important to take care of our energetic cords, not just for the relationship, but for ourselves. And it's important to be aware of how we feel inside when we're around different people. It's important to use our feelings as a compass and not necessarily take them as cold, hard fact, but more of like a guidance system, like a navigation system to let us know where a deeper healing can occur. And so I'm going to guide you through a nice, easy meditation to assist you in cleansing these cords. Get into a nice, comfortable seat. If you have some cacao, maybe go ahead and just take a little sip. exhale, this is gently opening of your heart chakra. So wherever you are, maybe with your hands in Gyan Mudra, your thumb and forefinger gently cross together. With your wrists on your knees, a nice gentle sway, side to side. Deepening of your breath. We'll start in through the nose and out the mouth, just releasing any stagnant energy. Maybe shrugging out your shoulders, circling your neck, continuing to breathe nice and deep. Inhale. And exhale. Feeling into your body and releasing any tension as you breathe deeply. Inhale. And exhale. Again. One more big breath, just like this. Inhale. Exhale. Beautiful. Now we're going to activate our Ujjayi breath. A deep yogic breath in through your nose. And then with a tight constricted throat, exhale through your nose. So you're kind of pushing out the air slowly but with controlled force, sounding like a beautiful ocean breath. Continue breathing in this way. Inhale. And exhale. Visualize vibrant ruby red light entering from the base of your spine, from the center of the earth. Connecting you to the grid of Goddess Gaia. Inhale to the base of your spine. And exhale as you feel gratitude for this connection with our Mother Earth. Continue breathing and feeling the base of your spine. And spiraling energies gliding. As you breathe deeply, inhale and exhale. Feeling your spine lengthen as your tailbone grounds you deep, cording you into the earth, abundant source of nourishment, breathing into the space of your home, for from wherever on this earth you may roam, you will always exist in your sacred home. Your body, the temple for your soul. On your next breath in, go ahead and breathe from the center of the earth. Now allowing the energy to enter your sacral chakras, Svadhisthana. Transmuting this energy to a bold, deep orange color. Maybe spiraling around your spine. Moving like you're in a pot of honey. Feeling the pleasure that exists in the present moment. Pleasure that exists within your breath. Slowing down. Allowing the pleasure of prana, life force, energy to flow freely to you and through you. Go ahead and switch opposite direction. Trusting the abundance of your breath. This constant source of life. Continue breathing from the center of the earth into your lower belly. Making any organic movements, whatever feels natural to you in this present moment. Breathing fully, releasing completely. There's nowhere else to go. There's nothing else to do but be here now. Come to a space of silence. Surrender, not needing your experience to be anything other than exactly how it is in this present moment. Allow yourself to feel your belly rise as you inhale. Maybe notice your shoulders melting down your back as you exhale. Softening to the space that's around you. As you continue breathing deeply, inhale and exhale. And on your next inhale, breathe from the center of the earth to your tailbone, Muladhara. Continue allowing this energy to travel up your spine, Svadhisthana, finally resting in your solar plexus, Manipura. Breathe into your stillness and feel the silence or the sounds, whatever exists around you in this present moment. As you continue breathing, inhale and exhale to your solar plexus, the space of your infinite power, the source of your authentic life force energy, the part of you that no one could ever take or replicate. Visualize a golden yellow orb spiraling in the center your solar plexus. Allow this power, this innate power, to rise within you. Feel the confidence of your existence, the higher purpose of your presence. Connect to this power as you continue breathing. Inhale and exhale. Release all that is not you. Let go of all of the conditioning of society, of friends, expectations. Let it all go. Allow yourself to shine bright as you were meant to. And as you continue breathing in this way, Muladhara, Svadhisthana, Manipura, holding your energy in Manipura, bring someone to mind. The first person, your gut instinct. Whoever this person is, energetically, they are here with you, right here, right now, sitting face to face with you. Breathe in their energy and allow yourself to feel whatever arises. Feel their presence and be with their presence. Notice their body language is speaking to you, or if they're actually communicating with you. What are they saying? Not what do you need to hear. What are they saying? Most often, those that we perceive as hurting us are deeply hurting inside. See them. Really see them as they are. without expectations or judgments. Witness them. When you get a clear message, maybe of what's really going on, see if there is a deeper lesson for you. Ask them, what are you here to teach me? And why now? Just allow the answer to bubble up. And breathe. Move with whatever arises, and breathe with whatever arises, without needing anything to be any other way. Exactly how it is in this present moment. See if there is any further messages that they have to share with you. Whenever you feel complete, continue breathing. Inhale. Muladhara, Svadhisthana, Manipura. This time take another deep breath in to your heart space, Anahata. Take your experience and allow it to lift into your heart center, alchemizing past into the space of unconditional love. The space where there is no pain, because the love is so strong that it encompasses the pain and encompasses the heartache and heartbreak. The love is so strong that it releases rejection, jealousy, and insecurity. The space of the heart, Anahata, Breathe into this heart space. Allow each breath to transform your experience with this individual, this teacher. Continue breathing into your heart space. Come to a soft space of acceptance, knowing that acceptance doesn't enable others to take advantage of us, doesn't mean that others hurting us is okay. Acceptance is seeing the past as a history book to learn from. Acceptance is not needing anything to change in order for you to grow. Acceptance is understanding and innerstanding. There is a greater purpose than we will ever come to know. And if you are having trouble finding this soft space of acceptance, accept that there's no wrong way to experience life, only your unique perspective. Acceptance is honoring your unique perspective and trusting your soul to guide you to its alignment. On your next exhale, visualize the energy coming back down from your heart space, anahata, into your solar plexus, manipura. Maybe gently rub your belly. Intuitively feeling your connection with this other individual, honoring their truth, their experience, their needs and desires, and not needing them to change in order for both realities to to exist. You stand in your power. Visualize them standing in their power. Maybe that changes the way the past could have gone. If both of you were empowered. Feel their energy cleanse the cords between you. Cleansed by your heart chakra, anahata. Send this energy back down, down, down with pleasure. Svadhisthana, down into Mama Earth, through Muladhara, allowing her to absorb any excess energies that are no longer serving you. And she takes this energy with love and absorbs it to transmute it back, like the mushrooms in the forest. Breathe in this renewed connection. Send your teacher off in peace, with many blessings. May they be blessed. For they may not realize it in this lifetime. You the blessing for them. May a blessing to you. Slowly begin bringing movement back to your body. And as you continue deepening your breath, together let's inhale. And exhale, hands come down, 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 watching over your aura, placing your palms on the ground to give love and healing vibes to Goddess Gaia in gratitude for all that she provides for us and heals for us. Thank you, Mother Earth. Thank you. Beautiful nature. This gorgeous blue spaceship floating in the middle of nowhere. Again, let's take a big breath. Arms lift up overhead. And exhale. Hands come down, down, down. Place your palms on your heart to give yourself love and healing vibes. Just give yourself those sweet vibes, but receive them as well. Receive the energy that you so lovingly give to all those around you. You are so, so, so worth it. With this renewed energy, you might feel the call to move around in your body. You dance or flow. Do whatever. what you need to do. And then whenever you are complete with your movement, go ahead, take your notebook, take your pen, get all cozied up, write a letter of forgiveness to yourself. Forgive yourself for anything that you desire. Forgive yourself for not being aware of the energies that you are allowing in your life. Forgive yourself for not knowing your worth, or how valuable your unique point of view is. Forgive yourself for anything and everything under the sun. And then when you feel complete, burn it. Burn it, baby, burn it. Watch it fall. To beautiful ashes. And from those ashes, you rise like a phoenix. You be blessed and be a blessing. So much love and blessings your way. Namaste.